everybody. My name is Christina Previtt. Welcome to the PT on Ice Daily Show. I am going to double check that I am actually on the ice. I am. So I am sorry that I am 13 minutes late. That is because I have been talking for 13 minutes on the Stave Off account. And I would like to say that this is the first time that I have done this, but it is actually the second. And I hope that I can blame pregnancy brain on the oops. But yeah, that is just something that is totally a normal occurrence in the life of Christina Previtt. So if you guys don't know me, I am one of the co-faculty for the Modern Management of the Older Adult with Dustin Jones. There is a lot of stuff that is going on with the older adult division and ICE in general. I feel like I am constantly getting these updates and it's really exciting. We are just about to finish week 8 of our online cohort for the older adult course this Sunday. And we have another cohort starting in the middle of March. So if you are interested in working with individuals over the age of 65, which I think you are, because at least a third of people in outpatient orthopedics, as well as the majority of our clients in home health and in acute care settings are going to be over the age of 65, you should jump on to that online course. I had a really great time last night talking to the virtual ICE students around arthritis management, and I really promised that I wasn't gonna go down a whole bunch of rabbit holes. I think I only went through one or two. And so if you guys, I don't know if the enrollment is up, I'm pretty sure it is now a continual enrollment, you should definitely get on board. And then the last thing that I'm gonna talk about, because it is coming up really fast and I am having a serious sense of FOMO about, is we have the PT sampler coming up in April where all of our faculty descend on Vegas and kind of talk about some of the content that they are looking through and navigating in their divisions. So I won't be able to be there this year, unfortunately. I'm like 36, 37, I guess fortunately or unfortunately. I'm 36, 37 weeks pregnant at the time. But if you are in or near that area, you should definitely go because there is going to be a ton of great content. Okay, so today we're gonna be talking about how the media is portraying aging. A couple of months ago, the Senior Rehab Project did an amazing podcast episode around the Golden Girls. And we could argue that the Golden Girls was probably one of the first examples of really starting to talk about and shed a very positive light on some of the things that we see as we get older, and just having a very positive and comedic outlook on some of the issues that we see as we get older into our retirement years. And it was a really great way to highlight some of the issues that were going on with aging and try to poke some fun at them, but also raise awareness. So if we fast forward now, we have quite a few examples in the media that I think are doing a wonderful job, whether they know it or not, of shedding light on some of the issues that we as physical therapists see all the time with an individual who is getting older, and provide a way for some of our older clients to talk to us about different aging issues, because they're being highlighted and they're almost being normalized. So I'm gonna talk about three different shows and I'm gonna highlight them in the end because you have to put them on your to watch list. I think they're all on Netflix. So you'll be able to watch them all, do it as a Saturday night binge fest, because you will not regret it. So number one is Grace and Frankie. So Grace and Frankie is a sitcom type of TV show that I think is in its fourth season. And it follows two women, Grace and Frankie, Jane Fonda and Mrs. Frizzle, but I don't remember what Mrs. Frizzle's actress name is. It'll come to me. But they are two women who had been married for over 30 years. And when they are 70, they find out that their husbands, who are partners in a law firm, are actually also lovers. And they have been in a relationship for over 10 years. And so at the age of 70, they go through a divorce and their husbands get married, and they are now navigating a very new set of circumstances where they are trying to learn different roles, their level of independence change, where they're living has changed, et cetera, et cetera. And through the show, which is just hilarious in general, they start bringing up some of these things that are going to be areas that I talk a lot with some of my older clients. So three examples from Grace and Frankie that have just come up in the short seasons that they've been around is, number one, there is an episode where Frankie throws out her back. And as she is trying to recover from that back strain, she tries to stand up and she slinks down to the floor. And because of the pain in her back, she cannot move. So naturally, she calls Grace and says, "Grace, like, I can't get up. I've hurt my back. I need you to help me." And Grace, who doesn't have a ton of physical reserve, tries to help her. She tries to pick her up, in the process also hurting her back, slinking down to the floor. And now we have two women in their 70s writhing around in pain on the floor, calling themselves floor people and being unsure of what they are going to do. So as a physical therapist, I saw the comedy of this, this circumstance, but I also saw like the reality of working in geriatric physical therapy. I'm sure my home health clinicians can really speak to this, where you have an individual coming in who has either had falls or had recurrent falls and does not have the physical reserve to be able to get up. So that's kind of flagging in your mind as you're speaking to them. But then you look at their primary caregiver and you realize that even if they did fall, the primary caregiver who's taking on the responsibility of managing the health of this individual also does not have the reserve to be able to help if there was some sort of circumstance. And so as the clinician coming into the home or as an outpatient orthopedic therapist seeing this interaction, you're definitely aware of how important it is to try and think about floor transfers, think about strengthening, because one, you don't want a fall to happen. Two, pain may be impeding physical function, and so if they were to hit the floor, the pain wouldn't allow them to be able to do a floor transfer successfully. And if they ended up on the floor, they're probably going to be calling 911, or they're going to be stuck there for a very long time because they don't have a caregiver that is going to be able to get them off the floor. So as much as this episode was really talking about, you know, just like this comedic situation that happened when they both end up on the floor, it really highlighted something really, really important in the world of aging, and in a way that it's not very threatening. So people are watching this, they're laughing, but in the back of their mind, they're also being like, "Oh yeah, like, I wonder if that did happen." Later on in that episode, they get one of those life alerts, and I love it because the life alert is ugly, it's cumbersome, and Grace and Frankie are both saying, "Heck no, I'm not wearing that ugly thing because it's embarrassing and I'm not going to do it because I want to maintain my independence, I'm totally fine." And I think that's another conversation, you know, like those falls risk bracelets, like how much do we want to put a sticker on our head that says that I can't get up off the floor when you're walking around in your day-to-day life. And so something that I think, again, highlighted something that we may be seeing in aging. And so we're starting to see more of the life conditions bracelets or the chronic conditions health alert bracelets being very fashionable now, because people are saying, "Well, if I have to wear them, I don't want it to be ugly." And so something that, you know, we're highlighting, that we're poking fun at, that's a joke, but at the same time is a really great way of raising awareness to this issue. So a second example in the same show is, as the season progresses, they talk about how now that they're not married, they have a certain sexual appetite, but Grace has pain in her wrist and arthritis that does not allow her to use some of the sexual tools that may be a way of releasing sexual energy. And we know that the individuals in their 60s, 70s, and 80s are continuing to be sexually active, and they may have orthopedic or chronic health issues that may impede their ability to do that. But it's also a generation of individuals who don't really talk about their sexual health and may put a lot of that underneath the rug and just not speak about it. In Grace and Frankie, in the second season, it is a big theme throughout, veined into the season around, you know, the fact that she does want to maintain sexual activity, that she wants to find resources that work for her body. And so she creates a tool to help her be able to do that. And so again, super hilarious. I loved the season. But an example of some of the positive downstream effects of that is I had a client in her 70s. We started talking about this show, and when she got to the second season, she was watching it as we were going through our plan of care. She kind of mentioned, like, she had a wrist injury, and she kind of mentioned to me that she actually looked up to see if that was something that was available to the public. And it started a conversation between the two of us because she did have pain in her wrist. She was relatively recently widowed. Her husband had passed away a couple of years ago, and she did have sexual needs and desires that she didn't feel were being met because she didn't have a partner, and she was looking for something to be able to curb that appetite. And so it was a way for us to have a conversation that sometimes on the side of the clinician as well as on the side of the individual may be really awkward to have, but through the filter of Grace and Frankie and kind of joking about some of the circumstances in the show, I was able to help her navigate that type of situation, and it ended up being a really positive experience for her and me. And I learned a lot about how I was going to approach those topics, and the fact that, you know, I may not be thinking about it all the time, but this is something that my clients are thinking about. And I know we have a pelvic floor physiotherapist on staff, and these are the type of questions that she asks in the form of self-report questionnaires before, so that individuals kind of have that veil of not being in a one-on-one conversation if those things come up. And so I thought that was a really, really great example of one of those things that happen as a result of aging that may be something to consider. The third example in Grace and Frankie, and I'm just bringing up a couple, there were tons if you really go through it with your PT hat on, is in the later season, Grace gets into a more serious relationship. And she is very, very conscientious of her appearance. She is always, always super done up. Jane Fonda in general is. She looks incredible. But as she gets into this relationship with this individual who tends to date women who are younger, she becomes very self-conscious about the fact that she has arthritis in her hip and should probably be using a cane, and does not want to be using a cane because it makes her look old. And she doesn't want him to sleep over because she spends so much time trying to combat any of the forward appearances of being older, like, you know, with the Spanx and all the makeup and not using the cane and taking Advil and trying to portray this very youthful, like, you know, like the way that she was in her 30s and her 70s and what that may mean, and if he won't like her anymore because she has been keeping up with somebody who is younger than her, but now she's feeling like she isn't, and this change in physical function. And so she ends up, you know, joking about having to use a cane because her hip is so painful. And I believe, I haven't caught up all the way, but I believe she actually goes through a replacement. And some of the issues that come up that aren't just how can your knee move, or should you set up a time for surgery, but how she's being portrayed with an intelligent gait, how she's being portrayed by using an assistive device. Do people look at her differently? Does she look differently on herself? And if we're working in the Jerry PT world, that is something that we think, oh, well, we're doing an assistive device because it's safer. But we need to consider all of those things because that's going through the mind of our client. And I think this show did an amazing job of shedding light on some of those perceptions. And I bet there's a lot of people who are watching who are shaking their head like, absolutely, that's what I'm thinking too. And so if we can kind of start these conversations through using Grace and Frankie, as kind of that filter, it may be a way for us to talk about some of the preconceived beliefs of our older clients and kind of have that conversation and work through what the best option is for them, given that they may accept a certain level of risk. So in this episode, Grace knew that she should probably be using her cane because it's so painful. But she was like, I know I should be, but I don't want to look like I'm an older lady with a cane. So I'm just gonna accept that my pain, my hip is gonna be flared up, or my knee, I forget what joint it was. And that's okay. She had the cognitive demand to do that. And I've done that with sports too. I'm gonna accept that this is gonna hurt and I'm gonna fix it later. But for right now, it's just gonna hurt. So a really cool example. So moving on from some of the examples of Grace and Frankie, another one that's become very popular in the media in the last couple of years is the movie The Intern. So The Intern is starring Robert De Niro and Anne Hathaway. And Anne Hathaway is this young CEO in this very hip, trendy clothing business, online business. And she hires a group of interns. And one of them is Robert De Niro, who is retired and going back to try and almost volunteer his time and learn about something in a new industry. And I loved this movie because it talked about, you know, we always think that as we get older, we slow down, we may be impeding, we may not have the same resources to learn new technology, for example. But to not fluff off the expertise and wisdom of somebody who has been in the employment game for 30 to 40 years and has a lot of experience on managing stress and some, like taking some of the technology that was very popular 10, 15, 20 years ago and applying some of the principles or some of the business principles in this case to some of the technologies that are happening now with some of the online stores and selling and all that kind of stuff. And so as you go through the movie, you start to see this relationship develop between Robert De Niro and Anne Hathaway, where she starts to really, really appreciate some of the skills and manners and professional conduct that you are seeing in somebody who is retired in their 60s and really appreciates coming and having the opportunity to learn and is really showing a willingness to be there, even though he may not have the same aptitude at some of the technologies. And it really is a nice positive way of thinking about how individuals at different times in their employment careers can provide a lot of value and are very, very meaningful as mentors and people who can help those who are younger to really, really build their skills. And so it was a really nice, like kind of heartwarming example of a way that we can try to encourage that collaboration between individuals who are new in their career and getting a lot of mentorship opportunities from some of their older peers who've been in the game a long time and are able to impart a lot of wisdom on some of their younger peers. The third example that I'm gonna talk about, and then I swear I will get off, I talk a lot, this is something that I've been really geeking out on, and plus I just get to watch Netflix, is The Book Club. So the last movie that it's come out in the last 2 years is The Book Club. So it is a group of four women who are in their 60s, 70s, who are in different stages of relationships. So you have one person who's been in a relationship for 30 years and are navigating the changes as they go into retirement. You have somebody who is divorced, somebody who is widowed, and somebody who has never been married. And so very different dynamics as they transition into retirement and what that means. And they have this book club where they discuss what's going on in their life, and it gives them that social support, and they encourage each other to get out there and you know, work with through different relationships and have these experiences, etc. I watched this on a flight, and my husband was so embarrassed because I was cackling with laughter, like hyena laughing, because some of the things that they come up with and they talk about in this movie are things that I have conversations with my clients about every single day. And so I'm just gonna highlight one stream because this is the one that's really resonated with me. In Diane Keaton's character, her husband passed away several years ago, and she is living in California, and her family is living in Sedona, Arizona. And throughout the movie, they say, well, mom, you're 70 years old, like you should be around your family, like what happens if you fall? And in the modern management course, we talk about this pre-traumatic stress disorder. This, even though there is no indication for falls risk or loss of independence, Diane Keaton is actually doing incredibly well if you watch her in the movie, but she's starting to believe because her daughters keep saying to her all the time, well, mom, you're 70, mom, you're 70, mom, you're 70, that she should move away from her friends and the life that she has created there for a long period of time in order to be in Arizona with her daughters. And in the process of this transition, she starts this love affair with a handsome pilot, and they talk about, you know, what it means to get older and what it means for her to make the choice around maintaining her independence as she gets older. My grandmother is 93. She lives on her own, still shovels her driveway, still drives, still does all of her ADLs and IDLs independently. And one of the biggest fights that I've gotten with my family is that they kept doing the same thing. Say, mom, wait, I'll do the driveway. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. But they work 10-hour days, which means that my grandmother is stuck inside instead of going to the Polish Hall, which she does every Tuesday. So she shovels her own driveway. And they're like, no, 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 it's going to be risky. You're going to be risky. But she accepted that risk. And it was the same thing, like, that they're having conversations about. She is physically doing very, very well. We have no concerns. But we're still trying to place this filter on her. And so stories like the book club, I think, are a really great example of saying, you know, this is really funny, but am I doing this? Because oftentimes we don't even realize it. We're coming from the best possible place in terms of trying to keep our loved ones safe, but are we kind of kicking their feet out from underneath them? And so again, this is a movie that, hilarious. I died laughing. Like, I've watched it 3 or 4 times. I cackle on the couch. But it also highlights some of these things that are very, very prominent as people transition through different life courses. And so something to think about as you're watching some of these movies, because as a physical therapist who works with individuals in their 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 100s, I think it's going to resonate with you in a very different way. All right, sorry again for being late. I pulled a total Previt moment. Everybody on faculty is gonna be laughing at me. I know. But the three things to watch on Netflix, Grace and Frankie, the episodes are only 20 minutes, so you can kind of just get like a little snippet of it every night if you don't have that much time to watch TV. The Intern with Robert De Niro and Anne Hathaway, and The Book Club. Do you guys know any other examples that are really highlighting positive aging issues or negative aging issues in the popular media? You should post them below, and we can continue this conversation offline. All right, guys, have a wonderful Wednesday, and I will see you all soon. Bye.